Toroid. So what is a toroid? A simple solenoid, you can see here, if you make it straight, it is going to be a solenoid. And if the two ends of the solenoid are made in this form, this is called a toroid. So if a spring shaped solenoid is turned and made made annular form, this is called a toroid. I can show you some other image of a toroid. This is also a toroid. You can see here, this is the core of the toroid, and turns are placed like this. So this is a toroid, and we need to find magnetic field when current passes through this toroid at three different places. One is inside the toroid, one is here, and one is at this place. At three different places we will find the magnetic field today. So if this is a toroid, you can see that the red ink, I have drawn a toroid, and electric current are passing through this wires, and from here this end the current is coming up, and in this end current is going down. Here again current is coming up, and here current is going down. Here again current is coming up, and here current is going down. So when current comes up, we use a symbol of dot, and where current goes down into the plane, we use a cross sign. These are the symbols. So this is the symbolic representation of a toroid and their currents, and we need to find a magnetic field at the center of the toroid. That means at any point which is at the center of the toroid. So let this be the point. And this is at a distance r, and if the you have seen that a toroid has two resistance, one is inner resistance and two radius, one is inner radius and other one is outer radius. So if inner radius is r1 and your outer radius is r2, so obviously your R is between, your R is greater than R1, greater than R1 but less than R2, and we need to find at a point P magnetic field at a point P inside the toroid. So let's go for the calculation. We can use a separate page for the calculation. So we will simultaneously see the figure also and also the calculations. So to need magnetic field, to find magnetic field at point P, we will draw an Amperian loop. So if this is be the Amperian loop, so your loop integral of B dot del L should be equal to mu naught into total current I. Mu naught into total current I. Since you know that every point here, if B and del L are in the same direction, so B, the angle between B and del L must be equal to 0. So it is going to be, and B is constant because B is symmetric. If you consider any point on this Amperian loop, every point is at a fixed distance, or it is a symmetric point. So every point on this line, which is at the periphery of a circle of radius r, has a fixed which is symmetric. So every point will have a constant b. So b is constant here. So if you integrate, then b will come out of integration. So loop integral of DLL must be equal to mu naught, and I is the total current. So if capital N is the number of turns, and if I is in each turn having current I here, every turn has a current I, suppose every turn has a fixed current, must have it, because they are it is a single wire and all in this form, so every wire will have the same current. So mu naught into, and if each of the wire has current I, so total number of current that is enclosing this Amperian loop will be a capital N into I, capital N into I, where I is the current in each turn. Now we can clearly see that capital N represents total number of turns. Okay, so B, and if you integrate this Amperian loop, it is going to be 2 pi into small r, which is equal to mu naught N into I. So your magnetic field B is mu naught, where capital N represents total number of turns, into I divided by 2 pi r. This much is your result, no problem. But if turn density is given, turn density means number of turns per unit length. So total number of turns per unit length. So here turn density is n, so capital N can be written as turn density into total length, and length of the wire here is going to be 2 pi r. Length of the wire is going to be 2 pi r. So we can replace capital N by n into 2 pi r. So your B is, magnetic field B is mu naught, and capital N can be represented as n into 2 pi r into I divided by 2 pi r. So 2 pi r gets cancelled, and your magnetic field at the center of this toroid is going to be mu naught N into I. Okay, so at this point magnetic field is going to be mu naught into turn density into I. N is your turn density. Turn density means number of turns per unit length.